Hi everyone, because this video, so straight away I want to say this video is nothing to do with my current series that I've got on YouTube, which is vlogging with melody-mae. So that's the only mention I'm actually going to have of that series. This particular video is it's going to be skinned my transitional journey. So I've not done a transitional journey video now for quite some time. I don't really know what's inspired me to do this. I think I was just flicking through some of my channel the other day, flicking through some of my videos, and I just saw some of my older ones, my transitional journey, and I thought, there's something I've not seen for a while. So I'm thinking this video is just gonna be a bit of a catch up. So it's gonna have all the hashtags, it's gonna have all of the references to transgender, being transgender, and everything like that. So a little bit about me. So I'm 46 years old, which is shocking, ridiculous, but I'm 46 years old. I'm male to female trans. I've been full-time since 2012, so 7 years, and it's crazy what I've accomplished in those 7 years. So I think that's one of the reasons why I'm doing this video as well. So part of the whole being trans support network and all that, but just wanted to kind of give a bit of an update with how my life has been since I went full time, since I had the operation as well. So I had the operation 3 years ago now. So you can see it there. So 14th of April 2016, which is crazy to think that I had my gender reassignment surgery over 3 years ago now. It's just gone so quick. So, but I just wanted to just give a little bit, you know, for anyone new who's watching this, a lot of people who may well watch this are going to know everything there is about me, especially if it's people at work. But if this video can just help out just one person who's just starting on their transitional journey, then that suits me. You know, I just want to be able to help people. I've kind of stepped away from the trans scene for a while now because it's the right way of putting this. I don't want to say because I don't need to be there anymore, because I don't really class myself as being trans anymore. I know I am, but I'm just a regular woman, regular job, regular life, that's it. So no big deal, no fusses, but I will never forget where I've come from either. So you'll have to excuse me. So this video, it has no script. I have no idea what I'm going to be talking about, so if I ramble then I'm sorry. I may even edit some bits out. This is just a bit of a chat. It's just nothing more than a chat, just to catch up, really. So full-time for 7 years. I went full-time when I moved down here back in 2011. I went full-time in 2012. Changed my name legally by Depol then as well, which was probably one of the single best things I've ever done in my life, just in terms of feelings. I mean, the feeling when I done that, the feeling when you get that certificate through the door, it's pretty special, to be fair. And even now, when I look at my title, when I say my title, somebody else says my title, Miss, just feels great. Just feels amazing. So yeah, so I started the very long process of jumping through lots of hoops, talking to different doctors, having different evaluations, pass different tests and that to determine whether, one, you could go on hormones, two, whether you can have the full gender reassignment surgery. And obviously gender reassignment surgery isn't the final outcome for everybody. Believe it or not, a lot of people never want to go that far. You know, that's fine. You know, everyone's different, of course. I did. Mine, you know, it's just my life, it's me. So I've not changed into somebody different. because I've always been this person deep down. I've always been this person for 37 years prior to going full time. I was always this person deep down. I just done a really good job of hiding it, basically. And the way my life was at the time, it just didn't allow me to be my true self. Obviously my life changed for various reasons, bad and then very good, thank you Dawn. And then I started to become the real me, or started to show the real me to people. So I was under a gender clinic now, I can't actually remember how long it was for, but it was for a few years. And you know what, it's really weird, but I actually missed that process. As stressful as it was, I suppose I can say that now, but as stressful as that process was, and as upsetting as it can be at times, I actually kind of miss going to the gender clinic. But like I say, you know, I had the op in April 2016, and I suppose you kind of distance yourself a little bit from all of that, because that's it, you've done it. You know, you've done everything you need to do. Most disappointing part of the entire process is the aftercare. In my opinion, okay, I was very lucky during my entire transition. I only really had one hiccup when I first got refused for surgery, but I knew that was coming anyway because I didn't have a job. So I knew that hiccup was coming. I didn't handle it very well. I've got an earlier video of I got home, I was crying my eyes out because I needed to lose a little bit of weight. That wasn't the real reason. The real reason was that I just didn't have a job. So my real life experience was nowhere near being complete because I needed to prove, you know, by having a job. I will never ever forget. I've got a lot, do you know what? I've got a lot to thank. My biggest thank you in life. That might be stretching it a bit, but one of my biggest thank yous, believe it or not, is my work colleagues. Because starting my full-time job, I had a couple of part-time jobs beforehand. I worked in a card shop, and then I worked at Sainsbury's doing a Christmas job, which I really enjoyed. But my proper test was working full-time. So I went to work full-time at B&Q, and I've actually been there for 5 years in January, which is crazy. I only kind of realised that yesterday, I think it was. So 5 years in January, that's mental. But I don't want to go mushy, but it just means so much to me just how I was looked after, treated equally, not treated different. But just treated how I wanted to be treated by everybody at my work. I worked in the same store for 5 years. I've worked with many different people. And from a staff point of view, I've never had a single, not one, negative comment or anything. I've been welcomed, made to feel normal. I hate that term, but you know. Helped to feel normal. I had a couple of blips at the beginning from customers, but I was always going to, because unfortunately life has created an awful lot of idiots, to be fair. Nothing you can do about that. It's how you deal with it and how you move on is what defines you. I had some wobbles. Work have seen me have some wobbles. I've had a couple of really big wobbles at work due to lack of confidence, and I still suffer now from anxiety, but I always get through it. I'm a ridiculously strong person. I've been through an awful lot. I'm not trying to make out I'm stronger than anyone else, but I'm talking from my own experience. I've put myself in some situations, I've been put in some situations, and I've always come out the other end. I've always come out better than when I went in. I'm not going to get upset, because this is a nice video. This is a good video. But I really just can't thank all of my work colleagues enough. I really can't thank B&Q enough, to be honest. Sued me for their special offers are rubbish at times, because they're not, I'm just joking. I don't care, because they've made me feel like a person, and that's all I've ever wanted. In terms of my home life is amazeballs. So I've got an amazing, amazing fiance, wife-to-be, recently proposed to me. So there's been two proposals. So I first proposed to her when I was, not me, when I was somebody else. So that didn't count. So by default, that didn't count. So I challenged Dawn when we was on holiday in Greece. We were sitting in a hot tub drinking ouzo. We was talking about getting married and engaged and all that lot. And I challenged a kind of tongue-in-cheek saying, like, I think you should propose to me again. And she said, no, you do it to me. Why should I? You know, you propose to me. So she did. We went to Dover Castle a couple of weeks ago and she proposed to me there. Got a video on that on my other series that I said I won't mention again. But that was one of my favourite days of many, many, many years. It was an amazing day for various reasons, but you know, my amazing Dawn proposed to me. So we're going to get married end of August is the plan. I mean, obviously there's a lot to chuck because we go to Greece again next September. So the plan is to get married the end of August and then our holiday to Greece is going to be our honeymoon. That's the plan, but obviously we don't know if the registry office is going to be available. I don't know. We've got some phone calls to make. So, in terms of my home life then. So, yeah, I've got a nice home. I was homeless a few years ago, which was single-handedly, easily, the worst time I've ever experienced. And I've been divorced, and I went through a divorce, and that was bad. But being homeless, literally having nowhere to go, was as scary as it comes for me. And that's something else as well. So, sorry, I'm jumping around a bit, but I'm just thinking of stuff as I'm going along. So I don't want to dwell on that too much because that's negative. I'm not being negative. This video is positive. But when I had my operation, I weren't scared, I weren't nervous, I was excited, I couldn't wait for it to happen. No, tell a lie, no, I'm going to tell a little lie. So I was a little bit anxious, of course I was. You know, you're going in for a major operation, you don't get much bigger than gender reassignment. But because I was so excited, because it's something that I wanted, it was a surreal time. I still remember and I still vision it and I still think about it a lot now. Walking down in my gown and very trendy slippers down to the operating room, holding Dawn's hand, as calm as anything. Dawn was a basket case, but I was as calm as anything. I remember sitting on the bed. I remember having the anaesthetist talk to me. I remember having an injection. And then before I know it, I remember waking up. And that's it. And that was my first ever operation. So, you know, it's not a bad way to start my operation history. Everything up to that point was amazing in terms of the care, I mean. As I said earlier in the video, no aftercare at all afterwards, which is disappointing. You have a 6-week review. I think it was 6 week, six or eight week, I think. Checkup, which was a waste of time in my case, because my surgeon, no, I didn't see my surgeon. My surgeon was Tina Rashid. But I saw another surgeon who was a bit of an arse, to be honest. He was probably the most difficult person in the entire process that we tried to talk to. But, you know, I ain't going to sit here and slag him off because he does an amazing job. But he's just a little bit eccentric. And then not much aftercare, and then I think that's where my life really started then, you know. Sat at home without a job for a while, then got a job. No, what am I on about? I'm gonna cut that bit. So yeah, so that's where I'm at the minute. So So I'm 46, 2019. I went full-time 2012. And wow, I've changed so much. My life has changed so much. I've recently got in touch with an aunt who lives in Ireland, and hopefully my uncle as well. I don't think they even knew, they didn't even know about my transition, which I'm a bit disappointed about, but they didn't know about it for whatever reason. I'm not going to dwell on that, but it's sad that they didn't know. I've had some really nice words off my aunt as well. She's really cool. I'm really pleased. So do you know what? I think I might go now because I just don't want to drone on. I think another reason, you know, why I've done this video is because I love vlogging. I just love vlogging so much. I love making these videos so much. It's probably my favourite thing to do outside of work. I don't even game as much anymore. I used to be a big gamer. I don't even game as much anymore. It's like I've come home from work today, and normally the old game in me would have been straight on the Xbox or something. But no, I couldn't wait to make this vlog. I really do get excited and look forward to them. So I hope you're enjoying the vlog. I hope you're enjoying my vlogs. But I just wanted to show people that you can be at your lowest being homeless. You can be at your lowest. You can go through something that's life changing, and I mean life changing. And you can come out the other end, and you can be, as far as I'm concerned, a person who is a million times the person who I used to be. I'm so happy. If I can do it, trust me, if I can do it with all my anxieties, if I can do it, then I think anyone watching this who's going through it, do you know what? You can do it as well. You can complete your transition, trust me. You know, I've been very fortunate to have the right people behind me, you know, and I have been, you know, I've been very fortunate there. But you can do it. You will complete your transition, and you will become the person that you are already, but you can just show it. So I'm thinking on that note, excuse me, I'm thinking on that note, I'm going to call it a day. So I've been talking for 18 minutes. Wow. Okay. So I hope you've enjoyed this vlog. Please subscribe to my channel, like and comment down below. And please get in touch if you are going through your transition, whether you're starting, whether you're about to, whether you're in it. I'd just love to help people, you know. I don't pretend to know it all, but I've been through enough to know a lot, you know. So if I can help anybody who's going through anything similar, then please get in touch with me. Because if I can help just one person with their transition, then you know what? I'm really happy. Thank you all for tuning in, and I'll see you all in the next video of my transitional journey. Bye.
Let's go, girls. Come on. I'm going.